We've published a new paper called Deep Decarbonisation, Green Hydrogen, Net Zero and the Future of the EU ETS. And as the title implies, one of the big themes in this report is the development of a green hydrogen economy in the EU. So what does that mean and why does it matter? Today, the European Union gets only about 2% of its total energy requirement from hydrogen, and all of that hydrogen is in the form of grey hydrogen. This means that it's produced via a very carbon-intensive process using natural gas as the input. But the European Union is in the process of legislating for net zero emissions by 2050. That is to say, within the next 6 months, we are very likely to have a legally binding target for zero emissions, net zero emissions in the European Union by 2050. That means we're going to have to scale up the use of hydrogen and specifically the use of green hydrogen, which emits no CO2 in its production. Green hydrogen is hydrogen that is produced via electrolyzers, via the process of electrolysis, using renewable electricity, wind and solar, as the power source for the electrolysis process. And therefore it's clean. That's the crucial point. And we will need ultimately to produce probably in the region of 15% of Europe's total energy requirement by 2050 if we are to meet the net zero target by 2050. And that means scaling up massively a new industry, effectively, green hydrogen. It means more dedicated renewable energy capacity. It means building up electrolyzers, these pieces of equipment that are going to be crucial in generating the green hydrogen. And it means building up the infrastructure capability, storage and distribution of green hydrogen across the European Union. So a lot of investment to come. The European Commission estimates that the investment required between now and 2030 to scale up green hydrogen will be anywhere between 340 billion and 460 billion euros. Sounds a lot of money, and it is a lot of money, but if you put that into the context of European GDP, it's about 3% of 1 year's GDP. So if you're amortizing that over a 10-year period, it's only 0.3% per year of European GDP. And in the grand scheme of things, that is not a lot of money. So the challenge here is not really going to be a financing challenge. It's much more a question of the logistics and building up that infrastructure capability. It will require public policy incentives in the form of subsidies and in the form of mandates, preferring wherever possible the use of green hydrogen over other energy sources, creating demand. But the good news is, in the European Union, we know how to do that, because over the last 10 to 15 years, we've built up another industry entirely from scratch, effectively, and that's the renewable energy industry. We've built up a huge amount of onshore and offshore wind capacity, solar capacity, and the cost of those technologies has fallen very dramatically over the last 10 years. The way those costs fell was, in the first instance, via the use of public policy subsidies. The subsidies attract private capital. The private capital and the scaling up produces economies of scale, and then you get technology improvements via the process of learning by doing. So we know that that can work, this virtuous feedback loop between public policy and private capital innovation, technology improvement, and we are positive in the outlook for green hydrogen and in the prospects for developing the same kind of virtuous feedback loop so that we can meet that net zero target ultimately by 2050. There's a lot more in the paper in terms of the detail, and if you're interested in finding out more, please contact your dedicated BNP Paribas Asset Management sales representative. Thank you.